Welcome to part two of this series of introductory video presentations on an introduction to Open Data Kit, a learning resource compiled by Statistics for Sustainable Development for researchers, students, or anyone else who may be interested in learning the fundamentals of ODK and mobile data collection. This presentation shall introduce the concept of XLSForms and cover the basics of their content and structure. Examples shown in this video will all be part of an example survey form partnered with this presentation, which you'll be able to download and explore. You may also use this form as part of a practice project to help familiarize yourself with ODK and mobile data collection. As for the contents of this presentation, we'll begin by exploring exactly what an XLSForm is, before moving on to their contents and structure, including the survey sheet, the choices sheet, and the settings sheet. Before diving into what sometimes can be a complex topic, it's best first to explain what exactly an XLSForm is. XLSForms are the first big step in helping to transition from paper surveys to digital surveys, and are essential to developing one's skills in ODK. It's essentially a standard form structure designed to simplify the creation of digital forms in Microsoft Excel. It provides a practical standard which is simple to get started with, especially given they are created using a simple and accessible tool in the form of Microsoft Excel. The more you are able to learn about the standard structure and syntax, the easier it will become to create more and more complex forms for your project. The big stepping stone will be familiarizing yourself to the fundamentals of XLSForms in order to build a foundation from which you can develop your skills. XLSForms can be uploaded online when you create a project in Kobo or Honor or whichever ODK aggregator you choose. These servers will automatically convert these into another format which is compatible with other sites and data collection apps on mobile devices. This will work only so long as your form fits with the standard structure and does not contain any mistakes. There is a site linked with this presentation which you can upload your form to and check that it is at least syntactically correct. So what are the contents and structure of an XLSForm? As alluded to, there are certain structural requirements any XLSForm must meet in order to function. Firstly, there are two sheets that your XLS workbook must contain. The survey sheet, which will contain the majority of your form's content. This is essentially where you build up the flow and the contents of your questionnaire. It will show all your questions, how they appear, all your groupings, and any constraints or skip patterns. The choices sheet will list all your answer choices for any multiple choice questions in your form. These two sheets are absolutely mandatory and must be included, otherwise your forms will simply not work. There is also a third optional sheet called the settings sheet. While not required, it will be good practice to familiarize yourself with how this sheet works and to include it on any form you construct. This sheet will add additional specifications such as default languages, form names, version IDs, form IDs, and even encryption options. So let's begin with the survey sheet. As mentioned, this is where the bulk of the form is constructed and will contain most of the form's content. Picture shown here is how a basic 7-question form could look in Excel. She will contain the full list of questions, including any additional notes to the data collector, and will have information about how they appear. There are a number of columns your survey sheet can contain, first three of which in this table are mandatory and therefore must be included. Relevancy of the rest depend on what additional requirements your questionnaire has, how you wish to structure it, and any customization options you wish to employ. Type. This column classifies what type of question or input your row is. It could be a select one, an integer, a date, a calculation. We'll come back to the different types of questions in the next presentation. Name. This contains the name which you are giving to your input. This cannot contain any spaces or special characters. It's best to stick with numbers, letters, periods, and underscores. Label. This is the main text which will appear on the screen for the question or note. It's worth knowing that you should be naming the language in this column, e.g. label colon colon English or label colon colon Spanish. You'll need to write the text you are wanting to appear in the correct language, as translations are not done automatically at any point in the ODK system. They have to be done manually. You can have multiple languages in your form, in which case you'll need a column for each individual language you want to use. Hint. This will contain any subtext you wish to go along with the questions. This will appear under the main label. They can be used for any purpose technically, though they are most commonly used for providing instructions to data collectors, such as do not read the options aloud, allow the respondent to think of an answer, and attempt to match it to one of the options shown if possible. Required. A simple column of yes or no, or true or false, telling the form whether or not this question must be answered. If the cell is left blank, it's assumed that it's a no.
relevant. You can use this column to code in any skip patterns by telling the form under what circumstances should this question appear, such as not allowing a question about how many children under 18 someone has when that person is in their 90s. Constraint. You can use this column to set what constitutes an acceptable answer for any given question, such as not allowing a negative number when you're asking for a distance. Constraint message. Working similarly to hints and labels in terms of languages, this column contains a message that would appear whenever an input answer violates the terms of the constraint you have set. Calculation. One of the types of input you can create is a calculate, which is an internal calculation which does not appear on the user's screen. This column is where you write the formula for this calculation, such as adding two other variables together in order to get a total. Finally, the appearance column. This is where you can set how questions or groups of questions will appear on the mobile device, such as minimal on a select one, which will show the answer choices as a drop-down list rather than all together. The choices sheet is where you define your answer choices for any multiple choice questions. As with the survey sheet, it will contain three mandatory columns. List name. This is the name you use for this particular list of answer choices and will correspond with the one used on the survey sheet with the question. For example, if you have a question asking for somebody's gender, you may have a list of options called gender, in which case, on the survey sheet, your type column would read select underscore one gender. The name column. This is the basic unique variable name that you give for each specific answer choice. Like with the name column on the survey sheet, this cannot contain any spaces. The label columns will work in the same way they do on the survey sheet, in that this is the text which will appear on the screen when you are collecting data, and you'll need a separate column for each language you are collecting data in. Each row represents an answer choice. And for those with the same list name, they are considered to be a part of the same set of choices. They can be reused for more than one question, so you do not have to create separate lists for each question. If two questions require the same answer choices, then you only need to make the answer choices once. Finally, the setting sheet, which though optional, would be good practice to utilize. This will contain some of the general settings about your form, such as its title, ID, version ID, a submission URL, etc. If some of these are left blank or the sheet is missing entirely, then some of the information is pulled directly from the Excel file itself, such as its name. If you're carrying out your survey in multiple languages, then you can use this tab to set which one would appear as the default. But of course, you can only pick from the languages which are used in the survey and choices sheets, as it is not auto-translated.
Just before I finish up, I'd like to show you in a little bit more detail exactly what an ODK form could look like in Microsoft Excel. We can see here down at the bottom that we have our three sheets, our survey sheet, our choices sheet, and our setting sheet. Currently selected, we have the survey sheet. As you can see along the top row here, we have all of our column headers that we need. So we have the type column, the name column, and the label column with English noted as our language of choice. Remember that these are the three mandatory columns that must be included. And if we scroll across, we also have all of our other columns, some which are used, some which are not. It depends entirely on your form. But in this example, we have columns including our hint, required, relevant, constraint, and constraint message. These are perhaps some of the key extra columns that you will need. But then we also have calculation, repeat count, appearance, a choice filter, a column for attaching media files such as images, and default, which will provide a default answer for a given question. Moving on to the choices sheet now, you can see that we have much fewer columns, but starting with the first one, we have list underscore name, containing all the names for our lists of answer choices. Of course, then we have the name column, which is the names for the individual answer choices themselves. And of course, still our label column, working much in the same way the label column does on the survey sheet. Similar to the survey sheet, I have an extra column here for media files, specifically images. This is not a common thing to use. I just included it as an extra in the example form, just as a little extra fun thing. And then finally, of course, we have the setting sheet, a much smaller sheet than the others, and obviously optional as well, though I would recommend using it
just as best practice so that you have a little bit more control over some of the options, such as a default language, as well as the ID and title of your form. As we can see, we have a few column titles, including the form title, the form ID, a version ID, and of course, we have set the default language here to English. Obviously, we only have English in this particular form, but if we had others, then we could set the default language accordingly. Just to summarize everything we've gone over today, an XLSForm is a standard form structure created to simplify the creation of digital survey forms using Microsoft Excel. They're a big stepping stone towards understanding and using Open Data Kit. Your XLS file will contain three sheets. The survey sheet, which is mandatory, is used to create the majority of the structure and content of your digital form. The choices sheet, also mandatory, is used to fill in all your multiple choice question answers. And finally, the setting sheet. This is optional, but is good practice to use it. It's used to define many of the settings about your form, including the default language. I hope you've enjoyed part two and look forward to welcoming you in part three, where we'll be going over question types in XLSForms.